All right, everybody, and thanks for tuning in to another Cosmology segment. I'm your host, Dan, a.k.a. Smash-O-Mash. This video was originally streamed live to Twitch at twitch.tv/Smash-O-Mash. And let's get into it. First, a globular cluster as photographed by Hubble. A glorious image here of a Milky Way galactic globular cluster, which is kind of like a small galaxy within a galaxy. A series of gravitationally bound stars that sort of all orbit each other or a central point. And this is an article from phys.org. We've got three of them today. So perhaps you'd like to check that out. It's in the Astronomy and Space section. This one's called ESO 520-21, also known as Palomar 6. Continuing on, we're going to look at cosmic rays here, several different cosmic ray monitors, at least seven of them, to see what's been going on in the past 30 days. Now, cosmic rays are important for all kinds of things. They cause things like spontaneous evolution of species, as well as cloud nucleation. Yeah, atmospheric effects from energy from space. We don't know many of the point sources, but we have lots of monitors, most of which are looking fairly consistent here. So looking at Hepatitae over the past 30 days, we see a significant downtick. How about Barentsburg? Significant downtick there at Barentsburg also. Leave us a comment if you're surprised about this. Let's go farther south to Athens, Greece. Here's the Athens neutron monitor, and we see a downtick there over the past 30 days as well. Let's go even farther south to Mexico City. A little flatter, but also a significant downtick at Mexico City. I mean, there you have it. It is a downward trend over the past 30 days. Sorry for all of you disaster enthusiast, catastrophist fools who think that cosmic ray flux is higher than it was in 2010. It just simply isn't. And here's your historic graph to show you that cosmic ray flux was significantly higher in 2010. Also, the thermosphere was colder in 2010. Read 'em and weep to all of you catastrophist hacks. So here's the OLU neutron monitor. You can see a downtick at OLU. How about DOMC Antarctica? A downtick at DOMC Antarctica and a downtick at DOMB Antarctica. Where's your grand solar minimum, folks? Where is your grand solar minimum? How come cosmic ray flux isn't as high as it was in 2010? Let's take a look at a massive galaxy. This massive radio galaxy right here is 2.2 million light years. And what these are huge radio lobes. So there are the radio lobes. This is the central galaxy. And this is another phys.org article. You're looking at radio astronomy here. The unusual structure of the radio galaxy J0133-1302. One of the interesting things about this one also, folks, is that we've got this crazy like bent tail here, which is a specific type of galaxy radio lobe. It's called a DBT, Distorted Bent Tail Radio Galaxy. Anyway, I'll just scroll the article here if you'd like to read it. Feel free to pause the video. Don't worry, we'll be here when you get back. So an interesting radio galaxy there, J0133-1302. And let's talk about lunar regolith. An exotic mix, mostly basalt, about 90% basalt. And then the rest consisting of some glass and other exotics, which do not appear to be igneous rocks. So another phys.org article here about the Chinese retrieval of some lunar regolith. Perhaps you'd like to read that. Perhaps you've already read it. Here's the astronomy picture of the day. It's the night of the Perseids. I don't really care. And I don't spend a whole lot of time particularly concerned about meteor showers. If you see a green meteor, it means nickel. Let's take a look at a random object. It's object number 1044 at the Neil Gerald Swift Bat X-ray Observatory, which, by the way, looks like this. If you head to the transient light curves. At the Neil Garrel Swift Observatory, this is what you'll see. Number 1044 is quasar PMN J2345-1555. There are the hard X-rays from that quasar. Let's take a look at it briefly on the CDS portal. So here it is in optical light. We'll zoom in. That's the DSS-2. That's the DSS. That's the DSS-2. A little bit higher res there. Here's the Pan Stars. A quite high resolution optical survey there. This does also show up in infrared. There is an infrared spectra, an infrared signature. Pretty bright there, pretty hot infrared spectra there coming from that quasar. And hey, quasars are galaxies, a specific type of active galactic nucleus where the galactic jet associated with the massive radio source at its core is oriented directly toward us, the viewer. It's just this side of a blazar. And it basically hides the features of the galaxy because we're looking down the barrel of the jet. And that's today's cosmology segment. We hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to check our other cosmology segments here at the Smash News Network, Least Busted Name in News. Lots of other cosmology segments in our playlists, youtube.com/smashamash/playlists.